rendezvous and feel starstruck.
Vince, the car's outside.
Got things to do, got to make my moves. I can't miss my flight and miss you too, boo. First class seats is overrated. Won't go unless they overpay us. Nowadays, I'm overdating my street for...
I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. It's hard to imagine this not being a fun game to watch. It's the Eagles going up against the Chargers. With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, we are a little less than 20 miles from downtown Los Angeles at the StubHub Center in Carson. I'll tell you, you wouldn't think 30,000 people could make this noise. That's half the size of a normal NFL stadium, but this is no normal crowd. They are ready to go as their Chargers get set to match up with the Philadelphia Eagles. Hi, everybody. Brandon Gordon alongside Charles Davis. And, Charles, we take a look at this Charger club entering play here. They come in feeling good after back-to-back victories. Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Eagles, we're in October now, so everybody should be coming into form, shouldn't they?
They really should. And what you have now is a full routine established about what you want to get done and full focus on the season.
This one taken from the 7, and he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. So here's the Charger offense making their way out. They'll be led out by their veteran quarterback out of North Carolina State. It's Philip Rivers.
And I thought it was a really nice performance last week by him. 3 touchdown passes. I think that signifies exactly what he was getting done. He did have the 1 interception.
But that's the ratio you say you're okay with, right?
If you go 3-1, you're going to be pretty happy over the course of a season. And let's face it, he'll never blame the receiver publicly. But behind closed doors, he probably told his agent, hey, what's the deal? I should have had a perfect game.
Now a play fake here on first down. That's complete. It's Gordon. So this brings up a 2nd and 2. Now it's a bootleg with Rivers. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jordan Hicks coming hard from that linebacker spot. He drops him for a loss of 11. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure it out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. 0 accountability, and a sack resulted. There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood what the 3rd down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that, bringing up 4th down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely 3-and-out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure they didn't give up much run after catch.
And a nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. First down, Wentz. And complete to Zach Ertz. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A good pickup there, 22.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance. So under the category of, while it can't be us because we're not that good, but could you imagine if this was you? LeGarrette Blount, his first 1,000-yard season since, what, 2010, his rookie year? And 18 touchdowns in the regular season? And no longer with New England.
He is over 30 now. He turned 30 in December. I don't know if that played a factor, but, yeah, such a productive year, and then he's gone.
Well, that just tells you this. Now he's going to be playing with a chip on his shoulder trying to prove something.
On play action, wins. Oh, and he'll just get rid of this one deep. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
10 yards still left on second down. Shotgun now for Wentz. He's going to air one out. This is taken in by Jeffrey. He's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Alshon Jeffrey, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Eagles have taken the early lead.
They went 5 wide in that offensive set. In racing, going 3 wide is a big deal. To go 5, how about the way that they finish things off?
Did you just fit a race car reference into the game?
Zoom, zoom. How about the way that you play? When you go 5 wide, that means you're going fast now.
Zoom, zoom indeed. He's got it, and the Eagles lead at 7-0. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. This is taken at his 4. And he is knocked down from the side. The Charger offense making their way back out there. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. The numbers a week ago from Melvin Gordon. 15 carries, 68 yards.
They've won 2 straight games and have done it with the running game as the focal point of their offense. So in this contest, I don't think about doing anything else. I continue to ride the hot hand that I've established and lead with the runners.
They'll only get a couple up to about the 30. Sack. Brandon Graham in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a 4th down.
Whenever you see a team deciding to throw the ball on 3rd and 1, as a defensive player, my mindset is we've got them now, and that's why they dialed up the blitz and got after them.
But occasionally, you want to pass it on 3rd and 1. I mean, not a lot for sure, but sometimes just to keep the defense guessing.
Oh, no doubt. You want to break tendencies as you go along with a game because you don't want them to just say, oh, 3rd and 1, we know exactly what they're going to do. But in this situation, as an offensive lineman, as a running back, I'd want to know why I didn't get the football.
Wentz now on 1st down. He's going to let this one go deep. So they took a shot on 1st down, but couldn't connect. Time quickly to look at the Chargers defense.
In 2016, the Chargers defense had its moments. They were ranked 10th against the run. Overall, total defense, though, they were 16th because they struggled a little bit against the pass, but they had a number of injuries, and they expect those guys back this year and expect to be an improved unit overall.
And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the gun, it's Wentz. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that's caught inside the 35. And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34.
Another big play by Alshon Jeffrey. I think his best days are ahead of him. I think he's ideally suited to help this young quarterback Carson Wentz develop.
He had 13 career 100-yard games coming into the season, and you know in the city of brotherly love, they're hoping for more.
Yeah, just think about Alshon Jeffrey, the catch radius and ability to make plays downfield against smaller defensive backs.
Throwing on first is Wentz. Looking here for Smith downfield. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. Wentz going to give this one to Blunt. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Now Wentz. Letting one go deep for the end zone. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four.
But that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
Yeah, and on third down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want six. Wentz to throw for it on fourth. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. Yeah, that is incomplete, but there is a flag. And on fourth down, this is a big call. So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Penalty flag for pass interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers, and somehow, some way, they make plays on the football, and sometimes you're there too soon.
Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the seven. Corey Legion able to swap him from that defensive tackle spot for a loss of five.
Well, surprise, surprise. First and goal at the one. No quarterback sneak. No running play. They decide to throw for it, but the pressure got to him quickly and put the quarterback down.
And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone. Back-to-back great plays defensively. You get the sack on first and goal. A great job in coverage there. All of a sudden, they're looking at third and goal from further back than when they started.
And the really good play callers look ahead and down in distance sequence. Now he's got a...
And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Jordan Matthews, his first touchdown on the year. And the Eagles had six to their lead. Point after now from Sturgis. And it's good to make it 14-0. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. A reminder, later tonight, the Colts, they'll be in Seattle to take on the Seahawks. And then Monday night, it's the Redskins getting a second straight night game as they'll head down to Arrowhead to take on KC. We're in October already. Can you believe it?
No, I can't. This one's moving fast.
First down, Rivers. He's got the rookie from Clemson, Mike Williams. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. And boy, they had high praise.